Waste is one of the key resources in the circular economy. There are numerous bio-based waste feedstocks which we can fully exploit to make new products like plastics, fuels, plant growth promoters, or even ingredients for livestock production. Just look at this. We produce massive amounts of wastewater, municipal organic wastes, agricultural residues, and even waste gases like biogas, which contain methane and carbon dioxide. And these are all hardly exploited resources. In the next few minutes, I will show you my thoughts on the potential of these resources and give an example of how we extract them in our lab in Wageningen. Now, these waste streams contain valuable carbon atoms, which serve as building blocks to make cool stuff. Currently, these waste streams must be treated or even to prevent pollution. However, the waste stream itself are of key interest to serve as resource in a bio-based economy. These so-called waste biorefineries are actual trending research topics. Now, currently, several companies are already starting demonstration factories to produce products from bio-based waste resources. For example, a US-based company called Mango Materials makes polyhydroxyalkanoates based plastics. You can check out their company movie to see what they are up to. Now, bio-based waste streams should be carefully selected to develop new products. The waste streams have different compositions which can make them more or less suitable for a certain catalyst. If there's a wet waste stream, then microorganisms may love it since they need water to live in. If you have the availability of a dry waste stream like straw, then a chemical conversion which is independent of water could be of benefit. Though we should be careful, of course, since, for example, wastewater is not directly suited for products that will be used for human consumption. So there must be well-designed factories which remove possible disturbing ingredients like medication residues. Now, personally, I do investigate with a team of students how we can use open culture processes to ferment bio-based waste streams into new commodity chemicals like caprylic acid. So we're not using a pure culture or GMO bacteria to produce a specific chemical, but available wild-type bacteria. Now, here you see several bioreactors we operate in our lab at Wageningen University. And we use a mixture of bacteria to convert a mix of waste streams into specifically desired chemical. Now, it really smells like something nice is brewed over here. We evenly do use electricity to provide additional energy to the bacteria to steer them in the right direction. And this way we are able to convert carbon dioxide into a medium chain fatty acid called caprylic acid. And this chemical is a potential new commodity chemical. So indeed, we do electrify our microbial friends to help them build the bio-based economy. So there are plenty of options to use waste streams as a resource. But are you still not convinced? Now, we humans waste about 1/3 of our produced food. Now just look at this number. There's 1.3 billion tons of food waste produced every year. And in Europe, each consumer is responsible for the production of about 250 kilograms of food waste per year. Just imagine that we can use this waste to produce 250 kilograms of products. Now that's a lot. Now there really seems enough waste to produce cool stuff, like biodegradable plastic packaging materials or even bio-recyclable plastic packaging materials. So at that moment, used bio-based products become the feedstock of new bio-based products. And that's what I call circular economy. And we are currently working on this idea. You see, there's work to be done and opportunities to grasp.